Joy and relief tonight after two trampers missing for 19 days in the Kahurangi National Park were found alive. Jessica O'Connor and Dion Reynolds, both 23 years old, had only minor injuries. Police saying they'd been without food for quite some time. The pair went missing at the vast national park west of Nelson, the second largest in the country. It's believed they entered the park near the Anaturi River car park in the west here. One News reporter Caitlin Ruddock joined searchers there last week and is with us live from Nelson shortly. First, how the trampers were found.
After 19 days in the bush, Jessica O'Connor and Dion Reynolds walking into Nelson Hospital under their own steam to meet relieved family.
Just before 1 p.m. today, one of our search helicopters, it was flying with RICO equipment, flew within their search area, and they managed to spot some smoke coming up from the area, and obviously went down to have a look and located two people waving up at them, which of course is a great thing for them to see.
Very briefly, so we talked to her about 30 seconds. She rang, the phone rang, and we said, hello, it's 30 years.
The 23-year-olds were winched by a chopper from Kahurangi National Park early this afternoon.
When they were picked up, they were chatty, they were in really good condition, a lot better than I thought they would be, given the length of time and the lack of food. But, yes, smiles and relief I could see in the photographs I've seen of them, and able to walk away from that helicopter, so fantastic. So they've been without food for some time, and I've yet to find out any more details about what they've been eating.
The pair were last seen entering the park from the Anaturi car park on May 9. Up to 50 people have been searching, along with an Air Force helicopter, a thermal imaging drone, alpine search and rescue teams and specialised search dogs.
It's pretty rare for us to have an outcome after such a long search that is so positive like this. There's a lot of work gone in the background to analyse how we thought they were, and we were very worried about them. But they did the right thing, and that's the message that we want to get across. They did the right thing, they stayed put, and they made themselves visible.
Heavy rain hampered search efforts in the past few days. Jessica O'Connor's parents never giving up hope.
I never had doubts about that because she knows what she's doing. So, you know, that was keeping her hopes up because she's very adventurous and she knows.
The park terrain is rugged and the area they had entered in was largely unmarked.
Initial indications that the pair became lost early on in the tramp due to fog conditions. At some stage, they both suffered minor injuries.
Tonight, the pair no doubt looking forward to a warm bed and a hot meal.
No doubt indeed. Let's go live to Caitlin in Nelson. Caitlin, the trampers' families, we understand, have arrived at the hospital. What more can you tell us?
Well, not only that, Simon, but we've just heard that Dion and Jessica have now been released from hospital. So we've watched as family members have come here this afternoon to Nelson Hospital, some even making that long four-hour drive from Arataurai all the way here to the hospital. But now they are reunited with their boy, with their girl, together and safe. There'll be lots of catching up to do, I'm sure. One family member, though, told me earlier today that when he saw them here, he said that they were in high spirits, and at the top of their list, they were wanting some pizza. So now they'll have had that chance to enjoy that, to enjoy the company of their family and friends with one heck of a story to tell.